fascinating it is that we have evolved from a single cellular body to this form.
Yeah, but this is not a single time process, you know. It takes millions of years to change into this current form from a single cellular form. And a single cell has a characteristics which changes with time.
Really?
Yeah, and the recent studies have shown that a single segment of DNA contains a huge amount of information.
Nice. I would like to simulate this evolution process through computation. Let us try.
You saw the conversation between Avni and Simran? Avni is trying to explain to Simran that there is some sort of randomness involved in evolution of species from one to the other. We all know that life started off as amoeba and now we are as Homo sapiens, humans. The randomness attached to this so-called explanation of what entails evolution can actually be simulated in C. The exact model is a little complicated. So what we'll do is we will try simulating it at a very different level. Well, yes, we can simulate and see how evolution has happened. In fact, there's a very popular topic called genetic algorithms, which does precisely this. It learns from evolution on how amoeba became human being. And that very process, one can mimic and use that as a sort of a technology to come out with brand new ways of accomplishing something. So what we'll do is, genetic algorithms per se is way out of the scope of this course. I will try to tell you something which is a very, very, very toned down version of genetic algorithms. In fact, biologists and people who actually know genetic algorithms might even complain saying, what am I teaching you people? But I'm teaching this in keeping in mind of the brand beginners in programming who may not have any idea about programming, either programming nor biology. But still, for it's a very interesting topic to just like that discuss and then write a piece of code for. So what we will do is we will take a huge binary string, let's say some 20 digit binary string. All of them are zeros. The rule is simple. You pick some digit randomly and make zero a one with a small probability. You know how to do this. You now are familiar with the random function, right? You say import random and then you can use a lot of functions within that. You're very familiar with it. Using that, you can do this. The point is, you take some digit in this 20 digit string, and in case that digit is a zero, you make it one with a small probability. Keep doing it, and eventually you will see that all these zeros will become ones. How much time does it take? It's based on the length of the string and the probability with which you switch zeros to ones. Sounds complicated, but don't worry, the program is actually very easy. Once you understand this, you can in fact go ahead and study what makes a genetic algorithm. But again, as I said, it's out of the scope of our Joy of Computing course, which is at a very foundation basic level. But you will have all the interest on earth to go and study and even understand what makes genetic algorithms. So let us now go ahead and see a screencast of how to execute this program.